Okay, continuing. Paint is all still wet. And when I got up, I noticed that I need more of this guy's body in here. So let me do that real quick before I forget. And I'm not going to try to make it distinct since there'll be straw there. And then also on the top, let me just go a little more here. There. I'm going to work on the straw just a little bit because it'll help me establish, keep my values under control, and also help me with the edges of where the pigs intersect the background. I'm going to use my large brush and use that darkest color that I mixed in the color mixing video, which is mostly raw umber, a little bit of a little reddish with some raw sienna mixed into it. So if you look at the straw, you see darkness as you look into it. And I find it's easier to paint that dark in now than to try to have light and dark and light and dark. I don't want this paint too thick because I'm going to be painting the lighter color straw into it, the texture of it. I'm going to use the next, the lightest gradation that has more of the raw sienna in it, right? And here you can see how the, a little bit lighter. Go back to a smaller brush and start to indicate some of the straw itself. I don't want to spend a great deal of time on the straw, just enough so it looks like straw. So picking up some of that color that I mixed with the raw sienna and some of the darker color. It does help to thin this some. Just get a little bit of texture. I'm going to get some white and yellow ochre too. Some of these lighter ones. You see how I'm just indicating the straw. I'm not trying to do a portrait of straw. pick up a little green. There's just a little bit of green in here that helps. As I said before, if you can find ways to work in little specks of the complement, the main coloration is pretty kind of pinkish, and having some of these green grass things in here helps to relieve that. A little bit of these really dark colors in here just to emphasize a little bit, especially right under the pig. There. So going back to my pigs, use some of the lighter color, just refine the back here a little bit. By painting in some of the background, the hay, it lets me blend in some of these things. It's okay to exaggerate them just a little. mixed up a little of this shadow color and a little more red in it than you saw when I did it on the color mixing tape. Mix a little more green into this. Can manipulate where I want the straw and the highlights to be to help define my edges a little better on some of these guys that we don't want it to get lost. going to make his ear a little bit wider here. And then I got to add back that little fringe. Mixing some raw umber and cobalt blue to get these eyes darker. I'm going to use a mahl stick. You've seen these before, where it just helps you steady your hand. By taking all of the color out of this brush, then I can just refine that edge a little bit. And a tiny highlight right there. And a little white of his eye right there. It's a little bright, but I don't think it hurts. When I paint in something like this, it's a detail, but it's not just a stripe. You really vary the pressure of your brush as you go down there, or it's going to look like some paint on top of the pig. I've been painting about 2.5 to 3 hours. I haven't really kept track, but as I'm doing this, the paints get a little stickier because of the liquid. And they're still very workable, but take advantage of that stickiness. It helps to control some of the texture stuff I'm doing now. But it does take some practice to know how much pressure to use. And it's just a little bit different feel of your wet into wet when the paint starts to get a little sticky on the canvas, and you could play with that and really use it to your advantage. This ear really goes a little more out into here. There we go. There. Add a little more red in here, even though the photograph is pretty bleached out because of the just the way the light's hitting it. But I want a little more. And then over here, starting to really use the paints thicker now. And I'm still painting wet into wet. The painting has never dried. Adding some magenta into this pinker color to make it a little darker without it being muddy. Though that's a little too bright there. I don't want to lose that leg into the straw, so it needs to be a brighter color. The edges of shadows, an old trick that goes back to the old masters, is when you have a transition between light and shadow is where your colors become more intense. And you can even see that here in the photograph. If you look, I don't know if you can quite tell on your screen, but do the same thing in here a little bit. So mixing in these browns and greens and just working on the texture and the values a little bit. I'm just using white here and mixing it into the wet color underneath. If I try to just match that color on the brush, then it won't end up being that color on the painting. So even though these highlights are not white, I'm using white, these little tufts here. Okay, I'm going to take a little break, and we'll do just a little more when I get back. All right, continuing, and we are still working wet into wet. The painting is not dried. Something I noticed when I got up is I need to make this ear a little larger in the front here. About like this. That's better. Let's paint in a little better the structure of the ear right down about here. While I'm at it, I should do this one. This ear could be a little bigger too. It's better to get these a little larger than smaller because they're one of the focal points of the painting is this the design where these reds interact with each other. Tone this leg down a little bit. It's a little too red. And just add some green to that. Okay, I still need a little more, a little darker in here. There, it's better. Back some of the texture though.